time, I'm recording a collection of songs I've never played live. So we're going into this recording session with some general ideas, but really leaving room for experimentation as well. Fortunately, I met this amazing guy, Adam Donovan, when we were looking for a tech for the KMFDM tours. He kicked so much ass there that we took him to Europe, and then he kicked so much more ass, and we find out that he's this amazing bass player and a sound engineer, so I really wanted to work with him on this next record.
I like that one. I mean, you tighten that up just a little bit, it'll be...
We were in the airport in Dusseldorf after the last tour, and Bradley started to mention to me that he was thinking about writing a new album, and I got pretty excited about it. You know, it's new stuff for Chant, always exciting, so... we talked about it for a while on a big long layover, and then about November he approached me and asked me to record the album for him.
All my drums are from scratch. I do use a field recording, and I layer everything from my garage door slamming or a door slamming to a couple of different design snare drums. I'd say about 6 or 7 layers in all to build up this drum pattern. Just electronically, which is in one of the new songs called Dead Muse. Yeah. A lot of times songs just form around noise and samples that I've collected, and I build it into a rhythm and it forms around that. And then these days, and for this album, a lot of songs came to me via a melody, and I had to find it on the piano, and I focused on adding a lot of synths and melody in it, and then the percussion came in actually second. Also, a good friend of mine, Rich, has been introducing me to a lot more analog gear. Here's some of the pedals. A good friend of mine, Devi Ever, has her company, Devi Ever Effects, and we've been using the synth mangler as well as this Chord Chaos pad. It actually made it on one of the new tracks, Create to Destroy. Got the Never Drive, the very Effector 13 vintage Sodomizer pedal, and a Silver Crank.
He had some scratch tracks for me to listen to that he had already recorded at his studio. So he asked me to do all the live tracking on the album.
We tracked the live drums at Evil Snail Studios in Austin, Texas. It was fantastic working there. The room sounds incredible. They got plenty of space for all the drums that I use for Chant. So it was just an ideal place to get the sounds we wanted.
It was a big challenge. We had about 24, 25 tracks of drums. We had room mics. Some drums had several mics on them. Since one of the owners of the studio is a drummer, the rooms were specifically designed for drums, so this was the perfect place to record Chant's new album.
That might be the one, man.
You live with these songs a long time before anybody ever gets to hear them. I think any artist will tell you that the excitement can go away and you start questioning the material you're writing. But, you know, you have moments in the studio where you hear the bass and the guitar and the live drums get layered onto what you've written, and everything starts coming together again. And it's small rewards like that that make this really exciting.